Hey, welcome. In this video today I'd like to show you one of my games played with this Fide master and how to play against them with the black pieces. We're going to see Caro-Kann Defense. His rating is 2440 right now, but when we played he had less rating. He was underrated maybe. So he played e4, now we played c6, the Caro-Kann. We have this variation, he played e5 and bishop to f5. Very nice move. He played this line, this short system, knight to f3. We have e6, bishop here, knight there, short castling, another knight developed, and now he developed his own knight. It is a very slow system actually, and it's a little more complicated. So implement this one many years ago, and this is a very nice system to use with white and black. So I played this move h6, the typical Caro-Kann move. He played c4, and now I think I had the opportunity. I'm not sure it is the best to play in this way right now. This idea is clear, to play this pawn, and after that with the recapture he can go with the knight on c4, and after that on d6. It could be his idea, but I captured the pawn, he recaptured, and now knight to d5. I have a fantastic knight on d5, right? And it's very difficult for him to do something about that. So he played there. I happily exchanged the bishops. I'm not sure about this either, but my bishop is very strong. Do you like the content? Subscribe in the video and turn on the notification bell. And this is why you can play the Caro-Kann, because it's an advanced French, right? We are going to play the French defense, something like French defense, with the bishop outside. He played this one, and in case we have the exchange here, and now I'd like to exchange more pieces, because I just would like to exchange some pieces, and then what he's going to do with this lovely pawn on d4. I'll start attacking that one. So he played b3, very nice move, waiting me to capture there in order to recapture with a pawn, and obviously I'm not going to do that. I developed my bishop, he played this one, and actually this is a very nice maneuver, very nice move, not to overprotect this knight, because he would like to recapture with a pawn, but he had another idea, very nice idea, and he played very nicely here. The idea is to play knight e4 and the other knight on d6. He would like to conquer that square on d6, maybe force me to capture on c4. Very nice move, explanation mark for that one, and I didn't realize it immediately during the game, but I cannot do much. I castled, he played here, now I played this counter-attacking move, knight to b4, because in chess you are giving something and you turn something back. So I am attacking the queen, and I'm highlighting this pawn here on d4. Now he has little problems how to defend everything. He played this one, very aggressive move, and he is threatening immediately to capture here on h6, right? So I played the prophylactic move, king h8, to avoid this tactic instantly and avoid any tricks with knight to f6. He has an aggressive position, but now he played this knight here on d6. I played knight to knight here, and now we have a lot of complications, because I'm threatening his rook, and not only his rook but his pawn on d4 as well. He can capture my own pawn here, but you see the game is complicated, and here maybe the best move that he can do is this sacrifice. He didn't do that during the game. He played rook to b1 and I captured a pawn, and now I'm threatening the double attack on e2, but he had this bishop sacrifice. I saw it afterwards with computer, difficult to see it, and the idea behind it is after this he can play queen h3. Here is a question for you: how are you going to play with the black pieces? It's not so easy, but he is threatening the pawn. Obviously we're going to protect that one, and here we have a wrong move, and the wrong move is queen to h6, because he can play this one, very nice move, attacking the knight and creating a discover threat. After this he can give the check here, and here it's a checkmate. So we should not go there, but we should play after that we should play here king to g7, and now you can repeat the moves like this, and this is a draw. And another mistake actually here to protect the pawn is to play bishop to... Hey, do you like the content? Now it's time to click the thumbs up button. Bishop here, right? I think this is a mistake. Here he can play f4 actually. He's attacking the bishop, after that the pawn. Maybe we have to play something like that. He can play something like this, knight f6, blocking this line with queen and bishop. And now what to do after that? He can capture first the pawn, second maybe this one. He has a lot of options here, and the position is very, very difficult for black in this way. So we have to play king to g7. King g7. Yes, this is the move. But he played here. I capture that. I'm threatening there on e2. He played this one, and now I finally captured. And now I played another move. I played another defensive move. Knight to f5, a nice move, because I'm attacking the queen and knight, so I'm forcing him to do something, right? And we successfully defense. And if you like this video, don't forget to click the thumbs up button. And here he played knight takes, we capture with that one. He played bishop here, and he has this buried bishop. So I start seizing his queen. I played that one. He played here again. I'm attacking him. Here's another move, and he is threatening something, right? He would like to play, not threatening immediately, but he would like to play e6 to open up this butter in order to dream to do something on g7. But you can see my lovely knight land again on d4. What a knight, right? I'm attacking the queen. I played this one. He played there, and now I performed a mistake. I don't know if you know it or not, but I'm going to give you a very important tip. Because if you are attacking his pieces, you have this feeling that I'm attacking, I'm in control, he should go back, and we forget about his threats. This move, queen to c2, has a threat, and the threat is obvious. He would like to capture my pawn, so I have to protect the pawn. Maybe to play something like queen to g5, or start pushing the pawns, I don't know, something like that. But I played rook here, and he just captured my pawn. This is very bad actually for me, but in any case, I played there to exchange queens, because again I have this lovely knight, and he has this very poor bishop on b2. So he played there. I start doubling my rooks. Now my position is clearly better. He played that one here. He would like to attack, to do something, and now I played queen to g5, lure the rook here, and now I have a counter-attacking move, and this is queen to b2. Very strong move actually, because I'm threatening the bishop, and this poor bishop don't have a lot of squares to go. But it's not only attacking the bishop, I'm attacking the rook. So his only move is here, and now again I have this deflecting move, queen to c2, attacking the rook, and again this bishop has a problem, right? He cannot do anything. He played desperately this move. I captured the pawn. He played that one. I give a check, of course, and I didn't just give a check. I give a check in order to create access on that square. And after that, I played this move. Knight here, now I'm attacking both of the rooks. What to do now? He played f5 to attack my own rook. And what are you going to do here, actually? It's black's turn. And I played this move, capturing a rook. Now he has to recapture my rook. And now I force him to resign with a beautiful checkmate. Can you find it? Very nice. If you seen my previous training programs, you can find easily such moves. This is a double attack, attacking queen and king. If he just capture here, this is a checkmate, the back rank checkmate. This is one idea. And the other idea is, if he goes here, we can take the queen with double check. So he has this move, the only move. And what are you going to do now? Congratulations. Queen to g1 is the beautiful move, attacking the king. This is the only move, and now this is a checkmate. Did you like the video? Right? We have a lot of crazy stuff there, and you're very welcome to click the thumbs up button, and I wish you to play like that and win title players. Thank you very much, and see you soon. Thanks for your time, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Here it's time for action. This is the initial page of my website, and here you can click Give me access to get access to free lessons. You can read this page, and if you scroll down, here you can add your name and your email. After that, you're going to take a free lesson, how to avoid chess blunders. So, time for action is now, and you're very welcome to join my mail list.